Hello dear friends, this is Dr. Muhammad Aminul Islam. Welcome to my channel. In my previous video, I explained how to interpret Langmuir adsorption isotherm model. This video has been very popular. Therefore, in this video, I would like to explain how to interpret Freundlich isotherm model. This video is very important, so please do not skip. Well, the primary assumption of the Freundlich isotherm model is the Freundlich isotherm model has a wide range of applications and is primarily used to the adsorption of multilayer heterogeneous surfaces and active sites with different energies. So considering these assumptions, Freundlich equation can be written as three forms, where Q equal to Kf C to the power 1 by n. And if you take log, then you get this. However, Freundlich equation can be also written as the classical form Q equal to Kf C to the power n, where Qe is the amount adsorbed at equilibrium, and Kf is the Freundlich equation constant, and n is the Freundlich exponential, and C is the equilibrium concentration. Now, let us consider the interpretation of this equation. Firstly, let us consider R square value or regression coefficient value. This is the primary consideration for adsorption data interpretation. If your data is showing R square value is greater than 0.999, then the isotherm data follows the Freundlich isotherm model. That means it is suggested that the adsorption of adsorbate onto adsorbent is multipoint non-homogeneous, which may be related to the heterogeneity of the adsorbent surface. In other words, adsorption of contaminants adsorbed onto the heterogeneous surface by forming multilayer, as I have shown here. So this is one consideration. Secondly, let us consider the Kf or Freundlich constant. It is one of the important parameters, and a large value of Freundlich constant indicates that there is a stronger interaction between adsorbate and surface, which means adsorption takes place onto the surface spontaneously, and that can lead to greater adsorption capacity. Although it should be remembered that Freundlich equation is not related to the maximum adsorption capacity. And let us consider n values, which is another important parameter for Freundlich equation. If your value is, for example, 1 by n between 0 to 1, it means adsorption takes place spontaneously. However, if 1 by n equal to 0, it means it is reversible. That means adsorption and desorption can take place simultaneously. On the other hand, if 1 by n greater than 1, it is unfavorable. That is, adsorption does not take place onto a particular surface spontaneously. However, we need to consider the limitations of the Freundlich equation. Freundlich equation is purely empirical, and the equation is valid only up to a certain concentrations and above which it becomes nonlinear. The constant K changes with change in temperature. And as I previously said, it cannot determine the maximum adsorption capacity. In my next video, I will explain the interpretation of other videos or other adsorption isotherm and kinetic models. If you have any questions, please feel free to make comment. And this is the reference from where most of the informations have been collected. And finally, thanks for watching. Please do visit Aminulchem Innovation and don't forget to subscribe this channel for more new videos. Thanks for watching.